equal to 1, 2 and 3 level. For that you need to know velocity as a function of n, right? You have to derive. From where you can derive? You have mvr and what else? Mv square by r. But what? K times E square by R square, right? You want velocity, you want to get rid of R. So cut one R from here and place it here. And then when you divide, R will go away. Fine? So you will get 1 by V is equal to, correct, right?
Yes.
So 1 by V is NH by 2 pi divided by K times
E square.
No, something is wrong. MV square by R is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught E square by R. I am assuming it E square by R square. I am assuming it to be hydrogen atom. Okay. So I will get MV square R is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught C square. Okay? And I also know that MVR is equal to NH by 2 pi. So if you want to eliminate R, you can just divide it. So V will come out to be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught T square into 2 pi by NH. So V is equal to E square by 2 epsilon naught H into 1 by N. Okay? So as N increases, velocity will go down.
Go down.
Now you will be able to get, right?
Yes.
From here, it's okay. You can put the value of E epsilon naught H, you will get the value of V. For different angles. Right now, next question. Radius of the innermost electron orbit in hydrogen atom is this: 5.3 into 10 raised to power minus 11. This is the radius of the innermost orbit. What is the innermost orbit? N equal to 1. Okay. You need to find radius of N equal to 2 and N equal to 3. N equal to 2 and 3. What is the radius? Should I do it? R1 is given. So once you get the ratio will be only in terms of n.
So you can do R1 by R2.
That's what I'm telling you. First get the expression. R1 is proportional to what? 1 by n square or n square?
N square.
Or n? R is proportional to n square, you said. Okay. So R1 by R2 will be n1 square by n2 square. You're getting the same thing?
Yeah.
R is proportional to n square?
Yeah.
Okay. So R, if it is proportional to n square, you can have R1 by R2 equal to what?
N1 square.
N1 by N2 whole square. So from here, I can get R2 is equal to N2 by N1 into R1. N2 is what? 2, 1 whole square R1. So it is what? 4 into R1, 4 times, so this is 20.6, no sorry, 21.2 into 10 is power minus 11 meters. Like that you can get for n equal to 3 also. For what? For n equal to 3 it will be 9 into this,
9 by 4,
right? 3 by 1 whole square, so 9 into that. Any doubt? These are all your NCERT questions. They are straightforward. And the good thing about these modern physics chapter is this, that there is not a big difference between JEE level and NCERT. So you quickly do the HC Verma exercises from these chapters and make sure you do not miss a single mark in any kind of exam for these kind of chapters. What are these kind of chapters? This entire modern physics, this then thermodynamics, class 11th. Okay, then entire class 12 physics, in fact, other than electrostatics. They're very, very straightforward. You should not lose any mark on that. It is easy to master it. That's what I'm trying to say. Fine. Write down next question. 12.5 electron volt. This much electron beam is used to bombard hydrogen at room temperature. What series of wavelength will be emitted? You need to tell me series. Which series? Limer, Balmer, Pasteur. Series of wavelength that will be emitted. Where this will go after absorbing this much, which level it will go to? How will you find? Did you get where it will go? How can you tell the answer? You have to first find out which level it will go to. After absorbing this much, electron will not be in its ground state. It will jump to the other state. Where it will go? To find that first. Minus 13.6 electron volt is the initial energy, E1. E2 will be what? Minus 13.6 divided by n square electron volt. This is energy in nth orbit. Fine. Difference in these two energies should be equal to this. This is what is absorbed, right? That is the third postulate, Bohr's third postulate. Minus 13.6 by n square minus of minus 13.6 should be equal to 12.5. So what is n? Divide by 1.1. How much that is? And then n is the square root of this. 13.6 divided by 1.1. Roughly how much it is? Don't guess. Try to solve. Huh? See, let me tell you, you guys have lot of lack of practice. I can see that. There's a huge, huge gap between where you should be at this stage and where you are. So don't waste any time. Practice a lot of questions. How much 13.6 divided by 1 by 1 roughly?
12 point something.
12? Yeah. Around 12. 13.6 divided by 1.1. Around 12 point what?
12.3.
It's 26. 22, 40, 12.3. Okay, so this is under root 12.3. Now, which integer comes close to this? 3, and equal to 3. It will not be able to reach 4. So it will come back to 3 and stay there. Are you getting it? So after absorbing this much, it will not be able to go to 4. So it will stay at the next possible level. It will not go up. It will be at n equal to 3. Now tell me, once it is at n equal to 3, what all series it can emit? Lyman and Balmer. It can go to n equal to 1 or it can go to n equal to 2. Fine? So the lowest level tells you which series it is. Lowest level as in, there's a transition between two levels, the lower of these two levels. Okay? So when it makes a transition from 3 to 2, it is Balmer, and when 3 to 1, Lyman, and 2 to 1 is also Lyman. So 2 Lyman series and 1 Balmer series. Ionization energy for hydrogen atom is 13.6 electron volt. How much this will be for helium atom? What it is for helium? How much? Into Z square. 54 around. let's do this question. There's a nucleus of charge Z times E. So atomic number is Z. Okay? E is a charge of electron. It requires 47.2 electron volt. This much energy is required to excite the electron from second Bohr orbit to third Bohr orbit. From n equal to 2 to n equal to 3, if you have to go, then this much energy is required. The ionization energy of hydrogen atom is given actually, 13.6 electron volt, which you know all anyways. For hydrogen atom, this is the ionization energy. Question number first, what is the value of Z? And its ionization energy is a second. Done. What is Z? You did not get the answer.
I'm still typing. We can take E equal to H. So we get lambda there. So 1 by lambda equal to R into Z square into 1 by H.
No, you're going lot longer way. Energy in the nth orbit for hydrogen-like atom will be what? 13.6 by n square into z square electron volt. Energy in the second orbit nikal lo. How much that will be? 13.6 by 4 z square. Energy in third. Wait. Third orbit will be 13.6 divided by 9 z square. Fine. So this minus that should be equal to 47.2, isn't it? Both are in electron volt only, so I don't need to convert in joules. So E3 minus E2 should give me 47.2 electron volt. That is minus of 13.6 by 9 z square minus of minus 0.6 by 4 z square is equal to 47.2. Okay. So from here you get the value of Z precisely. Fine. How do you get ionization energy? Its energy in first is the ionization mod of that is ionization energy. So once you get the value of Z, substitute here and put n equal to 1. You get that. You get minus of that. You need to supply that much energy to make it 0. Fine. So that is the ionization energy. Any doubt? How will you get potential energy of the electron in the first Bohr's orbit for this? Potential energy is double of the total energy. Again and again making the same error. Potential energy is double of this total energy. Fine? Next, how will you get angular momentum of the electron in the first Bohr orbit? How will you get angular momentum? Simply it is nh by 2 pi. Doesn't matter what is the atomic number. MVR should be equal to nh by 2 pi. Okay? So for n equal to, let us say 2. It will be what? 2 times h by 2 pi. So it will be h by pi only. It doesn't matter what is the atomic number. Angular momentum will be always equal to nh by 2 pi. Okay? Fine. So that's it for today. And we have finished one more chapter from modern physics. And you have to do a lot of practice. Lots as in every day at least 60 questions, 20 physics, 20 chemistry, 20 math, and you are not asking any sufficient doubts. Let me tell you, you are not yet ready to face the competition. Realize it. Otherwise, you should not realize it after writing the exam. You should realize it well before that you are not ready. Then only you will get prepared. Okay? And I am warning you in a way. that the consequences may not be good. You'll be then, I mean, I don't want you to go to some third grade college or whatever you get, or you pay a lot of money and then get into some college. So work very, very, very hard. Fine, so ask a lot of doubts, be active in a group, and follow it up and back it up with a lot of practice at home. That's it for today. You have the login for the test tomorrow?
I won't.
You won't. You have the login?
Yeah.